Okay. So, Hobgoblin, Bandit Lord, Goblin Lord. Damage equal to the number of goblins that enter the battlefield under your control this turn to any target for one red. Can you make a goblin deck? Maybe. I don't know. I feel like it's going to be definitely requiring uncommons to work. Otherwise, we're looking at Wizard class, which is blue, which apparently is bad. This is my third draft, by the way, of the format. Green Dragon, but that seems mediocre to me. Apparently, Purple Words Worm's okay, but we'll just take the Hobgoblin Bandit Lord and see where it takes us. Okay, so immediately I'm seeing Drider, which to me looks like a good card, but hang on a moment. Starting to get. Actually, oh, I found it. I found the right pick. Brisbane lost to Hawthorn. They had a fight back, but they still lost, so. It's pretty disappointing given I used my bonus round of tipping to get double points. But, you know, it is what it is. Looking like Sydney's gonna scrape a win. And then, ooh, Freo started playing. So I might have to go watch that in a moment. And by in a moment, I mean after. Right. How do you do damage to yourself in draft? You don't. Might I ever want to play this card? Yeah, it's early in the format. I'm just going to take the mythic. Right, we'll take a goblin. Combo. We could also take Monk of the Open Hand. You meet in a tavern. Draw spell for a creature deck. But yeah, we'll take Hobgoblin Captain. It can be pretty good and it keeps us only in red. So then we can look out for where we might go from here. This good. Should I be playing it? Gonna just stay in red. Damn it. Okay, we're gonna go green red go wide, I think. Pity this is a sorcery. And pity I have misread the signals horribly and should be in red white by the looks of things. I'll just take the two drop. And I'll take the two drop again. Okay. So, I think my previous statement is now not relevant. Maybe we can take this card instead of leather armor. I've seen some people play leather armor in constructed, but it's just so bad, isn't it? Okay, we'll take leather armor here over nothing. We'll take the monk. Take you can't block slash pump my dude. This might get played, maybe, who knows. Okay. Every draft. We take Meteor Swarm. It's not close. We've had it both of our other drafts, actually, and we have seemed to be preferencing red, but that's okay. We currently only have one goblin to go with our goblin ward, so that's not ideal, and there are no goblins. Oh, sorry, there is one goblin in this pack, but I don't think I should take it over Meteor Swarm, definitely not. Morningstar and Captain. The Morningstar's good equipment, and can make a goblin. And because we're in red-white, at least initially, I'm not sure I'll play this. I'm also not sure I'll play this one. But I might. I'll consider that one. We'll take the Morningstar over Hobgoblin Captain. This one makes goblins and is a goblin itself. Get in there. Right. Pretty sure I'm supposed to take this. I want to take double strike in my heart, but pretty sure this one's correct. Alright, we'll take the dueling rapier. Sorry, lack of commentary, but a bit distracted. Okay. None of these matter, do they? Nope. Pick the red card in case we get desperate. We could go mono red. Not with things like this, but, you know. Was I supposed to be in a different deck? I was not really paying attention very much on the signals. Got a bit distracted and just assumed that I was going to be in. Okay. Double strike card, please. Oh, okay. there's a fighter class. Search for one. Equipped costs 2 less. Not gonna be worth it, I don't think. And if it wheels, then that's great. But I think we just want swarming goblins. Ooh, this card. Pack tactics. Attacked with... you may sacrifice another creature, a little goblin, and then deal a little bit to a creature. Okay. Maybe not the best in our deck, but we're still going to take it. We're still going to take it. And put this in here, just in case. Just in case. Just in case. Now I'm wishing I took those. Oh, I have one rust monster. I'll just take the red card. We have way too many. Alright. Never didn't have it. Never didn't have it. I'll take the goblin card as well on the wheel, please. Right, our deck just got way better. Way, way better. Right, I'll take this. I don't think I'm playing it, but it's okay. We'll take the double striker. We have a lot of equipment to suit him up. Plus, it's a doggo. Good doggo. Could take a 2/1 or a fly. So we got there in the end, somehow. Definitely take the 2/2 over the paladin. We already have a paladin as well. Okay, let's have a look. So this card is big. Doesn't matter. Take this. Doesn't matter. Take this. Doesn't matter. Take this. Doesn't matter. Alright. So let's have a look. Now, because we have Brunor, we can play +2 mace very happily. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 of those. The Goblin Lord's terrible. Absolutely terrible. Have a number of 5 drops, so probably not going down that low. We could take improvised weaponry, but we're just gonna do this loot. Alright, and we're hoping to draw Bruno every game. We'll eventually draw a mountain. We have 9 sources of it, so should be okay. Okay. I guess they had to make it die to Dragon's Fire, but gosh, don't you wish this was a 5-4? Venture into the dungeon. Why are you playing this card? Surely it's not good. Dungeon of the Mad Maze. Interesting. How about I play this and then I free equip and make a 9-7, 9-5? Nice. And then I jump it and I deal you 10. Okay, still not great. I'll just attack. Actually, yeah, I'll just attack. Pass the turn. This is fine. What's the next one? Target creature can't attack until your next turn. That no, it's not lethal. Puts them to 1. Okay, let's do this. It's a good card, isn't it? It's a good card. I don't know whether I would be playing all those paladin shields. Well, let me rephrase. I wouldn't be. I think they're garbage. This is a keep. We'd like to draw a red land. Plains will do, but it's not as nice. Oh, a 1/3 death touch. How can I beat that? Fight. Four mana treasure fight. No, I liked that artifact. Well, I play this and then I don't attack. Is this a goblin? No. Okay. Pity no red source, so then I could equip an attack for 4, or attack for 3, rather, with menace. Druid class, sure. This person's gone big. Right, so what we do is we play a Hobgoblin Bandit Lord. Really? Excuse me. Oh, geez. Let's hope they attack us with a 5/5 dragon. Oh, man. Oh, man. Well, get this free attack in with Rust Must, Monster. I will gladly trade Goblin Morningstar for nothing. Wait, it has reach? God damn it. Jesus. Didn't realize it had reach. Whoops. Am I supposed to do this? I think I am. Oh, thank you. Thank you for attacking me. Gladly take it. I Yep. I think I am supposed to alpha. Cancel that. So then I do this, then they eat a 2 power thing, and then I play Devoted Paladin, and then surely I should be fine, and I should kill them, I think. This is not really how we drew it up when we drafted 6 equipments and Brunor Battlehammer, but you know. Oh, yep, they are dead. They are dead. Are they dead? Yeah, good enough. Smash. They're not, I don't think. They can block 3, block 3, go to 1. Pass the turn. Alright, they're not dead on board yet. They need to be able to block 4 creatures and play a land. I don't think we'll do it. Good game. Okay, so we beat Imerith. That's the thing with Imerith, it's like so good to draw cards, but you lose the hexproof status. I never got to play with Dragon Lord Ojutai, but be interesting to see if it was a similar kind of story there, but I feel like when I've tried to play it in Constructed, I've really wanted Counterspell back up, but not really found a good way to make it happen. Anyway, I will play this. Would love to draw just a 2-drop. Don't feel good, opponent. Hate you. Let's go with the attack you for 16. Would you like to block? I thought so. So you get plus two for each equipment. Oh, that's so good. It was already good when it was just plus two, plus O for when it's equipped. But now it's just like super gas. Yeah, we play this. Put this on this. Holy moly. This is good. Do I have them just dead? If I unequip Boots of Speed and put it there, then it's five. No, I couldn't have killed them. Alright, very good. You'll go. You got it. You played two creatures. Wait, I can do this. And then play a land. And then equip the Boots of Speed. So then it has haste. And then I have three lethal threats. That was pretty nasty. Alright, what's the football score? Oh, very wasteful so far. Oh no. There's a rust monster target. Just venture into the dungeon. Okay then. How about we attack? Then put that on that. What is going on? Round center's broken. Okay, so we took one and they've got a tapper. dog is annoying. I want to see the score. Yep. I'm just going to kill Horde Robber and attack for 6, I think. Like plus 2 mace would be good here. I guess I should change my, after this game I'm going to change the stream title, but if you're here, clearly you would see that we're both not. Oh man, that's a good card. Oh man, that's good. Love that. That has to have been one of the better draws in my deck. In fact, perhaps the best draw in my deck. We've got to remember that they are on 8 if they keep white open. If they target Blink Dog, then okay. So are they tapping Blink Dog? They can't tap it now. it's also a good draw. Now we put this on this. They tap that, then I attack with all these, and they take three and lose two of their creatures. Have to block two creatures. They were trying to dirtle away, and we would not allow it. We would not allow it. Alright, 4-0. Keep going. Just quickly change the stream title. Oh my gosh, 2 goals, 10. Ugh, I wish we could kick straight. Boots of speed, looking good again. I agree with LSV in that the 1 mana change from Crystal Slipper really did make a big difference. Okay, we're happy to see them playing this dumb thing. Definitely want a creature here. That's rude. Destroy Boots of Speed. Cave of the Frost Dragon could be a problem. This Plundering Barbarian's probably a pretty decent card, like a playable. Yep, I'll take one. Sure. I'll just kill that. Jeez. We've drawn extremely badly. Extremely badly. Alright. Well, the good news is, with six lands out of our deck, we're more likely to draw spells. We'll block this one. And they have the +2/+0. First strike. That's bad for me. That's a pretty decent draw. In fact, it's very good. Unfortunately, I have no way to deal with Cave of the Frost Dragon in one turn's time. What are they doing? 2 damage to it. No! Okay, we're dead. Yeah, we're dead. Had we had another mountain, we were not dead immediately, but they just activate Cave, and then they have a 3-turn clock in the air. And I don't really have much to deal with it. I have one fireball. I'd already used my... Wait, had I... No, I hadn't used my dragon's fire, but I have no dragon to buff it up to 4, so... one draw a card just crushes my 2/2. The mono white or missing a color. Well, we'll start with this attack. Don't ask me why I started with that attack only, because, yeah, that was horrific. That was bad. I'm going to save this and pretend that I actually have things to do. But I certainly, oh my god, another one. Nice. That is a lot of Priest of Ancient Lore. I will trade 2 of any creature for 1 of mine. Deal. Oh my gosh. They have four Priest of Ancient Laws. Four of them. This guy is my hero. I feel like they have. You heard something on the watch. But I'm going to play into it anyway. Fair enough. Unfortunately for them, they already gained a billion life. Though them just attacking with Steadfast Paladin is pretty good here. They get a trigger. I will. This says they don't have the first strike trick. Wait, no, phase out. Okay, that's fine. That does not matter. I thought for a moment, Yorion value blink, but phasing out does not blink them, which would not cause them to trigger twice, which would cause Celestial Unicorn to draw two cards. Oh man, that would have been bad. Anyway. Okay. They are playing creatures. I will also play a creature. I'll then pass. Does this have to be one of the attacking creatures? No, okay. Two life. Put a counter on that. Yep. What is that attack? It is savage. Okay. Ranger's Hawk can gain them a life next turn. And then they'll be able to go down the that route. That's a good draw. What can they have? Hang on, what would their block look like? That lose three creatures, kill it. Or lose Guardian of Faith Gloomstalker. I guess. Lost Minor Phandelver, so they're getting to draw a card in 4 turns time. We do attack with Tiger Tribe Hunter next turn. This has trample. Yep, fair enough. I should start attacking with Rust Monster. Wow, what is this? I don't know. What do they have? The first strike one. Yep, block. Okay. Okay. Why? My gosh. You know what would be good? Meteor Swarm. I want Meteor Swarm. I did think about killing Ranger's Hawk, but I felt it was not worth it. But maybe it was. Because this Ranger's Hawk is just gonna adventure for the rest of the game. And this is gonna get double strike. Gonna just continue to get value. Yep, can't do anything about that. I'll take 8. The vigilance on devoted paladin's trigger is legitimately good. Okay, so I can't just lethal them. That was an important thing to check. Yeah, that both just die. So they appear to be in much less of a good position based on those blocks, in my opinion. That's aggressive. Okay. That was the wrong block. I accidentally attacked with the other thing. They should have blocked this and eaten it for free. Definitely. Alright, so we're gonna suit up this goblin, I reckon. What are they doing? Counter on that, sure. Four, 7, 9. Ooh, baby. Ooh, baby. Free equip. pay to equip here. Oh, that was a horrific. Ah! Oh, I've played so bad. So bad. Yep. Attack with this. Absolutely should have just suited up one guy. Absolutely. Alright, they're currently dead on board. So, yep, draw a card. Makes sense. They did draw six extra cards this game. But it was not enough. And I played terrible. I'm sorry if you were watching that. Yeah, not what we wanna be presenting here. Right, 5-1. Three goals, 10-1 goals, 8. Well, fair enough. Hello, opponent. If a creature died, each opponent loses one life. Okay. We're not blocking. And then they get to anticipate, but put the, no, strategic planning. Yep. I feel like they're gonna yoink my creature and kill it. Interesting. They were gonna 3-for-1 themselves, but let's do this. Queen leather armor on this. Ah, okay. Any land, any land. Each player or each opponent. I'm gonna just send a message. No, that was. I decided not to be disrespectful. Alrighty. 6-1. Perhaps some of this is the ease of which we're moving through the ranks is due to the fact that we started back in bronze. Not quite as difficult as playing those who are up in the diamond ranks and whatnot. This bandit lord was terrible, for the record. Do I care about that enough to dragons fire it? Yeah, probably. It's just gonna be annoying. Okay, so we'd like to draw a white land and then a white land. No, a white land and then a red land. So I'm asking for out of 15 cards, we got a 50-50 chance. They're just gaining life. Not even attacking? Okay. Well, otherwise I would discard, so I'll just play it. Getting a bit mana screwed with our 17 land deck, but you know. If they play the hill, the 7-6, I'm just mega dead. Probably just mega dead anyway, because they can just attack for 6 until I can do something about it. Alright. I can do 8 damage to 0 targets. Right. We double block, right? I think so. Okay. I guess we don't get a choice. God damn it! Any land. Any land. We are not dead. I repeat, we are not dead. Now we're dead. That is heartbreak. Heartbreak. Sure, I was already gonna block. Because I have to, because I'm gonna die. Attack with all. Nice. Sorry about that, just having a bit of an ear scratch. Okay. What is the score? 20. Okay. 34 to 22. 4 goals, 10 to 2 goals. 10. Everyone's terrible. It's 7 o'clock. Okay. We have at least both our lands. This boy I haven't seen at all, actually. Let's go like this. We will trade. I feel like that should die immediately, and then we can pass. I really should have played land. Oh well. Okay, so they used no spell. Interesting. So they have a stop. What do they have a stop for? Do they have the bounce spell? Is there a bounce spell? Yeah, that one. Did I play land already? Can't remember. Turns out the answer was no. Okay. I got nothing left. Can you beat it? I'll take that as a no. Attack for 3, go to 18, I go to 19. Then I attack for a lot. Yep, you have to attack there. Now I just hold this. And then... This seems unwise. Game's opponent, interesting, their name was Test. Maybe they were testing the account, probably not. Alrighty, so unfortunately didn't have much success in the Arena Open, pardon me, being a bit unfamiliar with the standard format in its current form, mostly because my store does not play it at all. We ended up going 7-2 with this deck, and I was generally pretty happy with it. The format, at least from what I feel, is a lower power level, but it allows you to just play small creatures and punish people for being greedy, which was evident in ours. There were a couple of times, there's one particular game where we had Bruno and the Blink Dog, and it was disgusting, with Boots of Speed and whatnot. So there was a very good highlight game there. Meteor Swarm I cast at one time, I think, but triple red, even with 9 red sources, can sometimes be a bit dodgy. So there you go, there you have it. Until next time.